Hey guys, it's Kevin, and today I wanted to share my must-have accessories for the iPhone 15 series. If you didn't upgrade this year, don't worry, some of these will also work with older Lightning iPhones. With the holidays approaching, these will make great gifts for family and friends, or a little something for yourself. As always, I'll link everything I mentioned in the description box below, so let's jump right in. Okay, if you haven't heard by now, the iPhone 15 finally has USB-C, and it unlocks a whole list of things you can do with it. But the most useful, to me at least, is the ability to access an external drive like the Samsung T7. I can copy photos and videos I've taken straight to the SSD and view them on a Mac, or import them right into Final Cut Pro. No more AirDrop. You can also use a flash drive or an SD card. Plus, with the iPhone 15 Pros, you can record ProRes video up to 4K 60fps directly to an external drive. It's really convenient to copy and view files from any device, whether it's an iPhone, iPad, or Mac. I definitely recommend picking one of these up since the Samsung T7 is great for content creators or for backing up memories. Alright, this next one is for mobile gamers. Touchscreen controls are okay, but can get uncomfortable after a long period of time. But with the official PlayStation Backbone 1 controller, you can take your gaming experience to a whole new level. It basically turns your iPhone into a portable gaming console. You slot your iPhone right in and start gaming. No pairing or batteries required. If you have a PlayStation 5, you can use Remote Play to play your favorite PS5 games away from home. And some games from the App Store and Apple Arcade are supported as well. Since it's the PlayStation version, you find all the familiar buttons and triggers. There's even a PS logo on the back. I have the first gen model, but there's a newer one that's compatible with a wider range of phones and cases. I'm not the biggest gamer, but I find playing games more enjoyable on the Backbone 1. For this next accessory, I want to take a quick minute to thank Moft for sponsoring this portion of the video. So they sent me their Snap Phone tripod stand to review, and I honestly really like it. The stand aligns perfectly to the back of the iPhone every time since it has MagSafe. It's pretty thin too, and since I don't use a case, it raises the cameras just high enough so they don't touch the desk. To use the stand, just pull the outer layer and boom, it's that quick and easy. I actually use this mode the most because it's at a nice height when I'm at my desk. Plus, it's perfect for watching vertical content. But if you prefer long form content, you can still use the stand and rotate the phone 90 degrees. There's also a floating mode which raises the phone up to 8 inches high. Just pull the outer layer even further and the hinge will take over. It's really sturdy, so there are a bunch of angles you can choose from. As a content creator, I'm able to get different clips and angles from this one accessory. And it's super convenient to snap and go instead of fidgeting with clamps. The tripod can also act as a selfie grip for vlogging. I was very surprised how this little accessory can transform into a multi-purpose tool. Moft also sent me a Snap Phone case which complements the tripod stand perfectly. Both of these are made from their Movis vegan leather, which feels soft and durable. So I prefer larger iPhones because of the screen size and battery life. The iPhone 15 Pro Max can last me the entire day and then some, but on the go, I just need a little more juice. That's when the Anker Nano Power Bank comes in. It's a foldable USB-C port, so you don't need to worry about bringing a cable. There's a 5000mAh battery on the inside, and it can fast charge an iPhone about 10% in 10 minutes. I like how small and compact the power bank is, since it can easily fit in my pocket or backpack. Now that the iPhone has USB-C, this one port can expand into several different ones thanks to this USB-C hub, which is also from Anker. Basically, any hub will work, and they'll allow you to connect a wide range of accessories to the iPhone. For example, I can connect a power adapter to this USB-C port, which is strictly for power delivery, SSD via this USB-C port, HDMI cable for 4K 60, two USB-A ports for more accessories, an SD card and micro SD card, and an Ethernet cable. The iPhone doesn't have a DeX-like feature, but this hub is good in a pinch. And it can also be used with other devices like a Mac or iPad. During car rides, I use CarPlay and leave the iPhone in my pocket for safety. But unfortunately, my CarPlay unit is wired only, so it's a hassle to plug in the cable every time. But with this little adapter from CarLinkIt, you can turn any wired CarPlay unit to a wireless one. You just connect the adapter to a USB port and pair the iPhone to it via Bluetooth. It's one of those things where you don't know you need until you actually use it. If you don't know, I record all my videos on a smartphone, and the stabilization is pretty good. But using a gimbal makes it better. It also makes it easier to record videos with one hand. I had the DJI OM5, but it came with this clamp, which was a little hard to attach. So I made this MagSafe mount for a quick attachment. The gimbal also doubles as a tripod with the included grip. I normally use the stock camera app, but the OM5 has some nice features like shot guides and auto tracking. If you're into mobile content creation, a gimbal is a nice accessory to have. In addition to using a power bank, you can also use MagSafe to charge your iPhone wirelessly. It's similar to the tripod stand as it aligns to the back of the phone perfectly every time. I'm still using the discontinued MagSafe dual charger, but it gets the job done. It's not the fastest charger at only 15 watts, but it's nice to be able to plop an iPhone on and remove it when it's done charging. The next accessory is a no-brainer, but they're AirPods. The built-in speakers on the iPhone are good, but for more personalized listening experience, I use the AirPods Pro 2nd generation. But if you want to take your audio even further, there's also AirPods Max. They're more premium and sound better than AirPods Pro, but they still have that lightning port. If you combine these with gaming on the Backbone One, then you'll be in complete focus. They'll also connect seamlessly to the Mac, iPad, watch, and TV. And for the last accessory, AirTags. I don't normally forget my belongings, but AirTags give me some peace of mind. Plus, I'm getting older. If I ever lose something, let's say keys, I can track it because of the Find My network. And when you're in range, precision finding will help you pinpoint your items with more accuracy. And that's it for my 10 must-have accessories for the iPhone 15. All of these are great and you can't go wrong with any of them. Which one was your favorite accessory? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!